So I recorded this test script from the Selenium IDE, and normally it comes out as an unit test, so I'm going to actually convert this to an MS test. So what I did was I added a MS test project. So I just did new project at the solution level, selected test, I selected coded UI test, or a unit test itself is fine. And it created this template. I renamed some of the classes to Selenium MS Test Live Account Login. And I'm going to start copying the code from the script that was generated by the Selenium UI. So this was the script that was generated by the Selenium UI. And it's an end unit test that I'm going to copy over to the MS test. So I'm going to copy what's in the setup, and I'm going to put that into the constructor here. Actually, that's in the test area, so let me take it, put it in the constructor. I'm going to put some of the private member variables in there also. And again, this here is the end unit test that was generated by Selenium IDE. And I'm copying it into MS test here. So as you can see, I renamed it to MS test. And I should add Selenium here. And also add Selenium to the references. So let me copy this and paste it in here. And I'm going to add the references. So I'm going to do browse Selenium MS test third party. I'm going to add the Selenium . Okay, that looks fine. So I just added the Selenium references. I actually need string builder here, so let me just get that. And now I have to copy the method code in there from the generated file of Selenium IDE, which is specifically for NUnit, but it really is just the way they name the methods and nothing else. So let me just add that also, using system.threading. Okay, so I've copied the code. Now I'm going to compile this project. And I'm going to run the test. So you'll see that it's actually going to run remotely on this server because I've pointed it to another server, not the local. And while that's happening, there you go. So that's running. And the test basically logs into a Windows Live email account and signs out. So you see it's done and it passed, and it took 17 seconds here. So that was it. That was the demo of how you convert an end unit test into a MS test, and just using the Selenium IDE script that was generated. Okay, yeah, thank you for watching.